Good morning, children. Today we are going to start a new chapter, and that is called as evolution. So we have already finished human diseases. Now this is chapter 7, which is called as human evolution. Which is called as evolution. In this chapter, you will study many things related with origin of life, and then we will be discussing about how the evolution took place on Earth. Okay. First of all, let us discuss about certain things which you normally observe. For example, when you see the sky, you see the stars. The stars are actually emitting light. Now you know that whole universe consists of galaxies, and each galaxies consist of number of stars. Those stars are emitting light. Why the stars are actually very big in size, but why they appear very small? Because they are very, very distant apart from us. They are very far off from us, and you can also say that they are light years away from us. So it can be possible that if you are observing a distant star, it may be trillions and trillions away from you, and therefore you are observing the past of the star. That means even for a light, it takes millions of years to reach from the star to the eye, very near to the eye. You know that light travels with a very high speed, and so naturally you are looking at the past part of the star, not the present of the star, because the light which you observe very near to your eye, it is actually coming from the star millions of years ago. So when you observe things which are very near to you, you are observing it in the present form. But when you observe things such as stars, it may be possible that you are observing them when they are millions of years back, not in their present form. You are not observing in their present form, but you are observing it of the past star as such. So now let us talk about certain things about evolution. But first of all, let us talk about the origin of universe. Now it is assumed that the universe originated about 20 billion years ago. Billion years ago. During that time, there is a particular theory called as Big Bang theory. You must have heard about Big Bang. Big Bang theory. According to this theory, in the past, a huge explosion took place, unimaginable in physical terms at present. It is unimaginable that huge explosion took place, and then the universe expanded, and finally the universe cooled down. All the gases and the dust which was present, they start settling down, they start to condense, and which are responsible for all the present day galaxies, planets, stars which we observe today. Now this took billions of years ago. About our Earth is about 4.5 billion years. The origin of our Earth took place about 4.5 billion years ago. It is about 4.5 billion years old. At that time, it was very hot, consisting of molten mass. Now, no atmosphere was present on the Earth at that particular time, because the molten mass in form of volcanic eruptions, when they start oozing out from the Earth crust, they were responsible for forming certain gases such as methane, ammonia, water vapor, and carbon dioxide. Due to ultraviolet rays of the sun, the water vapor, it broke down into hydrogen and oxygen. Now, oxygen combined with other substances to form gases such as ammonia and methane. Now, hydrogen being lighter, it escaped out. Oxygen, it combined with certain other substances to form gases such as carbon dioxide. The water vapor, water was present in form of water vapor because of the earth temperature was very high. Slowly the ozone formed in the stratosphere. Because of that, slowly the temperature of the earth cooled down, and now the water started to collect in the depressions of the earth crust. All the depressions were filled up by the ocean. Now, how all this happened, we don't know, because this happened billions of years ago. About when the earth was formed, about 4.5 billion years ago, there was no life. Moreover, the earth was of reducing type of, earth had an environment of reducing type, oxygen was not present. But what happened was that, gradually, as the earth cooled down, the water started getting accumulated in the all the depressions of the earth crust. And finally, what happened was, about 5 million years ago, after the earth was formed, the first acellular form of life arose. See, I am telling you acellular form of life. That means it did not have a cellular component as we know it today. Cellular form of life did not evolve first, but acellular form of life evolved first. Now, there are certain hypotheses as how the first life evolved from the on the earth as such. Now, we are going to discuss all these theories and hypotheses. Okay. First of all, Greek thinkers believed in theory of panspermia. Theory of panspermia. They believed that the life do not arose in the earth. The life did not arise, but the life has actually, origin of life has taken place outside the earth. And they came in the earth in form of spores. We see all the meteors hitting the earth as such. So, in the meteors, these spores might have come to the earth. So, this is how the life started on the earth. So, according to them, they believe in theory of panspermia. Then, during the medieval period, people started thinking of theory of spontaneous creation of life, spontaneous generation of life, They thought that life must have arise from straw and mud, from the dirt, because they observed that in the all the organic debris matter, the matter, organic matter which is decomposing, you can see lot of flies there. So, they start believing that it is just because of dirt the life evolved. But that this was soon discarded by Louis Pasteur in his experiment. The Louis Pasteur performed an experiment in a closed flask. He heated, there was a broth nutrient present and live yeast was present. He started heating this live, the broth containing the live yeast, and the yeast died after some time. Now this flask was closed and he observed that no living form was, after some time he observed that there was no living form here now. Since the flask was closed, no living form evolved in this particular broth. So when he broke the front part, or you can say the anterior portion of the flask, and this flask was now in contact with the air present outside, he observed that now the living forms start appearing. So Louis Pasteur was the person who said that life evolved from pre-existing, life evolved from pre-existing life. He was a person who was responsible for saying that life evolved from pre-existing life. That means life have to be present, then it can evolve a new life. Life evolved from pre-existing life or pre-existing cells. So the theory of spontaneous generation was discarded. Now there are certain other theory which were put. For example, one more theory was put by Oparin of Russia and Haldane of England. Oparin of Russia and Haldane of England, they put theory of chemical evolution of life. According to them, the life evolved from non-living organic matter. Non-living organic matter such as RNA and proteins were responsible for evolution of life, according to them. And this was actually proved by S.L. Miller during their experiment. Now, this is a diagram representing the experiment of S.L. Miller. Now, let us have a look at this diagram as such. See, you can see the experimental setup here. They proved that the evolution of life has taken place due to organic matter. Now let us see how it happened. You know very well that during the millions of years ago, when the earth was formed, the earth was very hot. The climatic conditions were of humid nature, of reducing nature. Oxygen was not present. Moreover, it was very hot. So they developed, S.L. Miller developed a condition very similar to the primitive earth. Now in this flask, you can see the electric discharge. You know that during the millions of years ago, when the earth was very young, there was lot of lightning, volcanic eruptions, and the temperature was very high, and therefore here electric discharge is kept in order to maintain the temperature of about 800 degree in the flask. This flask contains certain gases, for example NH4, CH4, water vapor, NH2, which was available during the primitive stage of the earth. Moreover, this is a condenser, here water can enter inside and here water can leave. Now, this is connected to vacuum, this is a boiling water from which we get the vapor form of water vapor. We can get water vapor from here. Now, this whole process was continued for some time and it was observed that amino acids were formed here in this part. Now, similar experiments also, very similar to this, other experiments concluded that not only amino acids, fats, lipids and fats and carbohydrates can also be formed. So, you know that our cell is made up of lipid bilayer membrane along with protein and carbohydrate. So, naturally, very similar kind of cells might have arose, very similar kind of structure might have arose, but yes, the first form life was no doubt, it was made up of RNA, DNA and protein, complex RNA, DNA and protein. These were the first life forms, that is non-cellular in nature. Now, how these RNA and DNA first form a non-cellular form of life started replicating, this phenomena we don't know. How they developed the art of replication, we surely don't know about this thing. But yes, the first form cell from the non-cellular form of life, living matter, might have developed not before 2000 million years ago. Not before 2000 million years ago. So, naturally it took a very long time for a non-cellular living organism to get converted into cellular form of life. It took a very long time. So, from the cellular form of life, you already know the fact that there are two kinds of cell, prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. Prokaryotic cell are basically called as ancient cell because they lack cell organelles, and moreover their ribosome is of 70S. You will learn these things about the ribosomes later on in your class 11th as such. But yes, you know definitely that there is a difference between prokaryotic form of life and eukaryotic form of life. Prokaryotic form of life do not contain cell organelles. Apart from that, they do not have well developed nuclear envelope around the nucleus. Eukaryotes are more advanced in this way that they have all the cell organelles as well as they have well developed nuclear membrane around the nucleus. So, it is assumed that prokaryotic form of life must have given rise to unicellular eukaryotic form of life, and from that unicellular eukaryotic form of life, which we know as present day, they belong to present day kingdom Protista, that must have evolved and given a rise to animals and plants. So, this is all about this particular topic. We have discussed about the origin of life in my first topic. In other topics, in the next lecture, we will be discussing about evolution, especially taking place on Earth. Thank you very much. Have a very nice day.